हेलो ऑल, आई एम मिसेस मधुरा तुळजापूरकर. आई ब्रिंग अप न्यू वीडियो बेस्ड ऑन बुक नंबर 2. सो फर्स्ट चैप्टर आई सिलेक्टेड इज द हीट एक्सचेंजर, बिकॉज इन एवरी एग्जाम द न्यूमेरिकल्स आर आस्क्ड ऑन द LMTD एंड हीट कंटेंट बेस्ड ऑन द LMTD. सो LMTD इज द लॉग मीन टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस. इट हेल्प्स टू ड्राइव द टेम्परेचर टू नो द हीट ट्रांसफर. सो मोर इज द LMTD, मोर इज द हीट ट्रांसफर. सो लॉग मीन टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस LMTD इज गिवन बाय Δt1 माइनस Δt2 डिवाइडेड बाय ln Δt1 अपॉन Δt2, वेर Δt1 इज इक्वल टू डिफरेंस बिटवीन द हॉट एंड कोल्ड फ्लूइड एट वन एंड ऑफ द हीट एक्सचेंजर एंड Δt2 इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन हॉट एंड कोल्ड फ्लूइड्स एट द अदर एंड ऑफ द हीट एक्सचेंजर. And Q, that is heat transfer using LMTD, is equal to UA LMTD, where U is the overall heat transfer coefficient for that exchanger and A is the area of the heat exchanger. Now while solving the numericals based on the LMTD, you have to refer first the type of the flow. So there are two types of the flow: counter current flow and parallel type of the flow. So if you see, this is the diagram of the counter current flow, where fluid is entering in one pipe from one side and the other fluid is entering from the other side. So both entrances are opposite to each other, and if you see, the one fluid is leaving from one end and another fluid is leaving from the other end. So they enter from the opposite direction as well as they leave from the opposite direction. Whereas in the parallel flow heat exchanger, if you see, both the fluids are entering from the one direction and they are leaving in the one direction. So while calculating the Δt1 and Δt2, you have to focus on which type of heat exchanger it is. It is the counter current heat exchanger or it is a parallel type of the heat exchanger. And accordingly, you have to mark the temperatures and find out the Δt1 and Δt2. So now let's solve the numerical number 1. So milk is flowing in a pipe cooler at the rate of 0.95 kg per second. Initial temperature of the milk is 55 degrees Celsius and it is cooled to 18 degrees Celsius. Using a steered water bath with the constant temperature of 10 degrees Celsius around the pipe, the specific heat of milk is 3.86 kJ/kg degree Celsius. Calculate the heat transfer rate and also LMTD of the heat exchanger. Now it is given as milk is entering at 55 degree Celsius and cooled at 18 degree Celsius. So while leaving, its temperature is 18 degree Celsius, and the constant water bath at 10 degree Celsius is used to cool that milk. Okay, so this is a saturated temperature, 10 degree at the entrance level as well as 10 degree at the exit level. So Δt1 is hot temperature minus cold temperature, which is 55 minus 10 is equal to 45, and Δt2 is again hot temperature minus cold temperature, which is 18 minus 10 is equal to 8. So again, just substituting the values in the formula, LMTD is equal to Δt1 minus Δt2 divided by ln Δt1 upon Δt2, I get the answer as LMTD is equal to 21.4 degree Celsius. Now it is asked to find out the heat transfer in the cooling milk. So heat transfer in the cooling milk is given by the formula mC Δt. So m is given as 0.95, c is given as 3.86, and temperature is given as 55 minus 18. So now the answer is in kilojoule per second. We want to find out the heat content in kilocalories per hour. So I convert it into kilocalories. So 1 kilocalorie is equal to 4.18 kilojoules. So I just divide it by 4.18 joules. So that answer is 32.46 kilocalories per second. I have to find out heat transfer in terms of hours. So I just multiply 32.46 multiplied by 3600 to convert seconds into hours. So I get the answer as 116,856 किलो कैलोरीज पर आर हीट कंटेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट हीट कंटेंट्स आर ट्रांसफर्ड इन द मिल्क. नाउ सेकंड न्यूमरिकल इज अ काउंटर फ्लो डबल पाइप हीट एक्सचेंजर. सो इफ यू सी केयरफुली इट इज गिवन एज इट इज द काउंटर फ्लो हीट एक्सचेंजर. यूजिंग अ हॉट प्रोसेस लिक्विड इज यूज टू हीट वॉटर विच फ्लोज एट 20 meter cube पर आर. द प्रोसेस लिक्विड एंटर्स द हीट एक्सचेंजर एट 180 degree Celsius एंड लिव्स एट 130 degree Celsius. द इनलेट एंड एग्जिट टेम्परेचर ऑफ द वॉटर आर 30 degree Celsius एंड 90 degree Celsius. स्पेसिफिक हीट ऑफ द वॉटर इज 4.18 kilojoule पर केजी केल्विन. कैलक्युलेट द हीट ट्रांसफर एरिया इफ द ओवरऑल हीट ट्रांसफर कोएफिशिएंट इज 820 watt per meter square kelvin. व्हाट वुड बी द परसेंटेज इंक्रीज इन द एरिया इफ द फ्लूड फ्लो वेयर पैरेलल अज्यूमिंग सेम ओवरऑल हीट ट्रांसफर कोएफिशिएंट. ओके सो हियर हॉट प्रोसेस लिक्विड एंड वॉटर आर द टू फ्लूइड्स. नाउ हॉट प्रोसेस लिक्विड इज एंटरिंग एट 180 degree Celsius एंड लिविंग एट 130 degree Celsius. वेयर वॉटर इज एंटरिंग एट 30 degree Celsius एंड लिविंग एट 90 degree Celsius. सो इट इज अ काउंटर फ्लो हीट एक्सचेंजर. सो बोथ लिक्विड्स आर एंटरिंग इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. सो वॉटर इज एंटरिंग एट 30 degree Celsius एंड लिविंग एट 90 degree Celsius. Whereas liquid is entering at 180 degree Celsius and leaving at 130 degree Celsius. Now as per definition, delta T is a difference between the hot liquid and cold liquid. So it is 130 minus 30 is equal to 100, and delta 2 is again the difference between the hot and cold. So 180 minus 90 is equal to 90. So we get delta T1 as 100 and delta T2 as 90. So just substituting those values in the equation, we can find out the LMTD. So LMTD is here 94.91 degree Celsius. Now heat content in the water, we can calculate as per the definition MC delta T. M is given, C is given, it is M is given in 20 meter cube per hour. So I calculate it, I converted it into kilojoule per hour and into 4.187. So it is 1395.6 kilowatt. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3600 kilojoules. So with the help of this conversion formula, I convert it into the kilowatt. Now heat is also, heat transfer is also given by the formula UALMTD. So now U is given to you in the equation. H you know, LMTD you know, you need to find out the area. So by substituting the values, I get the area as 17.9 meter square. Now it is asked in the numerical that if the flow is parallel, then what will be the change in the area? Okay, what will be the percentage increase in the area? So now you have to assume that the flow is parallel, means both fluids are entering in the same direction. So water is entering at 30 degree Celsius and leaving at 90 degree Celsius, and liquid is entering at 180 degree Celsius and leaving at 130 degree Celsius. So as per definition, again find out the delta T1 is equal to hot fluid minus cold fluid. We get answer as 150, as well as delta T2 is equal to 130 minus 90. We get answer as 40. So find out the LMTD. We get LMTD as 83.2 degree Celsius. U is given to you. H you know, just substituting the values, find out the area. So now there is an increase in the area, which is 20.45 meter square. So you have to find out the increase in area in terms of the initial area. So increase in area is 20.45 minus 17.9 divided by 17.9. So there is an increase in area by 14.24%. Now next numerical is very simple. In a counter flow heat exchanger, cold fluid enters at 30 degree Celsius and leaves at 50 degree Celsius, whereas the hot fluid enters at 150 degree Celsius and leaves at 130 degree Celsius. The LMTD is, now if you see, the liquid is entering at 30 degree Celsius and leaving at 50 degree Celsius. It is the counter flow, so another liquid is enter from the opposite side, so which is entering at 150 degree Celsius and leaving at 130 degree Celsius. So now delta T1 is equal to hot minus cold, which gives me 100 degree Celsius, as well as delta T2 is again 150 minus 50, which is 100 degree Celsius. Now when delta T1 is equal to delta T2, then you have to consider that LMTD is equal to delta T1 is equal to delta T2, which is nothing but 100 degree Celsius. So this is the last numerical. A heat exchanger is to be designed to condensate the hydrocarbon vapor mixture from a distillation column at the rate of 11 kg per second, which is available at its saturation temperature of 120 degree Celsius. The latent heat of condensation of the hydrocarbon vapor mixture is 450 kilojoule per kg. The cooling water at 32 degree Celsius is used in counter current direction at the rate of 58 kg per second to condensate the vapor mixture. The specific heat of cooling water 4.18 kilojoule per kg degree Celsius. Determine LMTD and area of the heat exchanger surface if the overall heat transfer coefficient is 600 joule per meter square second degree Celsius. Now here hydrocarbon liquid mixture is giving its latent heat to the water. Okay, so whatever heat gained by the water is nothing but the latent heat lose by the hydrocarbon mixture. So latent heat is given by m into l, mass of the hydrocarbon into its latent heat coefficient, and the heat gained by the water is mc delta t. So just substituting the values, we can find out the temperature of the water which is leaving the heat exchanger. So water leaves the heat exchanger at 52.4 degree Celsius. Now let's draw a diagram of double pipe heat exchanger. Now we know that that hydrocarbon is at the saturation temperature 120 degree and water is entering at 32 degree Celsius and leaving at 52.4 degree Celsius. So now this is the counter current heat exchanger. So delta T1 is equal to hot temperature minus cold temperature, which is 120 minus 32, 88 degree Celsius, and delta T2 is equal to 120 minus 52.4, which is 67.6 degree Celsius. So just substituting the values in the LMTD equation, I get the LMTD as 77.35 degree Celsius. Now with the help of heat transfer definition, I get the equation as MC delta T is equal to UA LMTD. So now M is given as 58, CP is given as 4.18. So this is the heat gained by the water is equal to heat gained with the help of the LMTD. So heat transfer coefficient is given to you, LMTD I know, I can find out the area. So area is 106.5 meter square. So if you have any queries related with the heat exchanger numericals, you can write me at energyauditor2021@gmail.com. If you like the video, just give a like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.